What is up people, this is YSHQ and in this part I'll be completing the servo clock project. So this is the last part and the first thing that you'll see is the code that I wrote, which was just for marking out the points for the minutes and hours. So what I did was I found out the minimum and maximum values for the servo motors individually. Then I took an average of them and I used that value to get the perfect value for the minutes and hours. The minutes are divided by 5 minutes per slot and the hours 1 minute, 1 hour per slot. Now if you see over here, the motor moved by just 5 minutes and this is all due to the code that I wrote. What it does is that if it goes to 0, I'll mark it, 1 and I'll mark it, 2 and I'll mark it, and so on. And I'll just keep doing this process till the end for both the minutes and hours. The only difference I had to do was to change the channel and remove the other motor. That's it. And this is the setup that I'm using, the PCA9685 connected to the servo motors and the board connected to the Pi. Out of retroreflective panels, can't just speak it. Now this whole thing is held by 8 screws and a lot of tape. So in the next part we'll be seeing how everything is held together. So if you see over here, I just removed the motor from inside, just so it is easier for me. Then I removed the top two pointers. This is the whole back and front and the side. Now these are the motors. Both the motors are mounted to a piece of PVC aluminium sheet. That is the front. The three screws hold the back together. Now I removed two of the screws from the back just so it would be easier for me. And these two screw holes are for mounting the motors. Now let's open up the back. I'll just take the screwdriver and I'll open it up. I had to use long screws because it was more stable using long screws rather than short screws. And there the slot for the servo motor wires, as you can see. And I'll be using that slot to just pry open the back. I'm making this much more difficult than it really is. Okay, so got the back off. Now the back is cut in the same way of the front. I just traced out the lines and cut it off and sanded both of them together so both are equal. Next, what we see inside are these things. Now these are wires which I taped on just to act as spacers, because if you see over here, the motor shafts protrude out in different ways on both the different motors, and hence I had to add some spacing. So for that I used that wire. Now I removed the side one. Now this is the retro reflective panel. It is about 0.5 millimeter thick and it's thick enough for the use. And these are pen pieces which I cut out, which perfectly fit the screw, and the screw threads into it, so it acts as a spacer for the model. I remove all three of them, and these are the wires which I showed again. That's the hole cut out for both the motors from before when I first attached it, and these are the markings. Now if you see on the shafts, what I did was I took a metal shaft which is available in small toys and everything, and then I just threaded it on there. That's it. Now for the working part. What I did over here was I kept the hour as it is and I just changed the minute to seconds, just so it is easier for me to record it, because my phone doesn't have a lot of memory and hence it would just clog up. So thank you people for watching this video. Like this video or dislike it. Subscribe to the channel, share it, go through my other videos and playlists, and see you next time. Ta-da!